Everyone, Omix here, time for more Smite, and today I'm gonna show you how to use Skadi, the winter goddess, or the goddess of winter, whatever you prefer. And as always, if you enjoy this kind of content, just leave a like down below and subscribe to my channel. And if you're up for it, you don't need to, just comment that you have liked and subscribed, and I'm going to reply to you shortly. And now, more Smite. Hello again. This is Skadi, the goddess of winter. She's Norse, she's ranged, and she's a hunter. She's a physical hunter. And guess what? She high crowd control. Well, I can see it, really, in some places of her abilities. But she's a pusher. Well, to people who don't know what pusher means, it means take down towers, phoenixes, titans, a pusher. Push your minion wave up. A pusher. Understand? Anywho, and just to be clear, this is my build. If you don't like my build, you can do your own. The same goes to the abilities. And about abilities, what matters the most is 1 to 10 is the one that matters the most. And the rest from 11 to 20 is just a fill out. And when you are in the 20-ish level, when you are in the 20s, you'll get the cap on all of your abilities. So, no further ado, let me show you how to build items and relics on her. And after that, abilities. So, I started with Death Tool because she's a hunter. Because of a passive, hit an enemy with basic attack, restores 8 health and 3 mana. And because she's a hunter, I'll go for the attack speed and 100 more mana. But after that, I ran into a small problem. Well, you see, she don't have a lot of mana, and she's a hybrid between an ability user and a basic attacker. So that's gonna be quite a strain on her mana. So if you don't like Hydro Lament, the better choice, or the choice you instead want to have, then I prefer you and points you to, if I can show you. I can make this crap. There you go. Instead of Hydro Lament, you can also take Transcendence. Instead of gaining for 8 seconds after using ability, your next basic attack will deal an additional 30% damage. And the passive next one is this item grants 2.5 MP5 per 10% of the mix of mana. That's going down fast because you don't have any mana. So if you don't want to have that, and because I want to Hydro Lament is because of the cooldown, of course, you can take instead Transcendence, because physical power, more mana, and MP5, flat MP5, you need to at least lose 50% of your mana to get more MP5 than Transcendence, just so you know. And the passive on Transcendence is passive. You permanently gain 50 mana per stack and receive 5 stacks for 1 god kill, and 1 stack for 1 minion kill makes 50 stacks. Additionally, 3% of your mana is converted to physical power. So, in a sense, if you have 100 mana, you gain 30 physical power? Maybe. But you're probably on the tutorial, right? So I don't know which mana I'm gonna take, but for this build I'm gonna take Tyrus Lament. However, I don't know how the match is going to be, so I'm just going to leave those two open, okay? The next one is Frostbound Hammer. The reason is, enemies hit by basic attacks have their movement speed reduced by 30% and have their attack speed reduced by 50% for 1.21 seconds. Well, she's an ice-cold woman, so it actually worked with Frostbound Hammer. And because she's a hunter, she needs some kind of lifesteal, so I took Asti because of the attack speed, 15 physical level lifesteal, and 15 physical penetration. If you drop below 35% health, you gain additional 25% physical lifesteal for 5 seconds. So you gain 40% lifesteal, that only occur once every 50 seconds. And if I manage actually to kill something, I take a Blood Forge. Kill an enemy guard of forges and shield from their blood with health equal for 200 plus 10 per pay player, 200 plus 10 per player level for 20 seconds. While the blood shield is active, you gain 10 movement speed. And because she's a basic attacker also, Soraya took rage. Earning a kill or assist fills you with rage, increasing your critical strike chance by 20%. Debuff stacks up for 3 times and lasts 8 seconds. And like I said, I don't know which and where I'm gonna put my items really, but this is my item build nonetheless. Next one is relics. I took Heavenly Wings because movement speed, attacks penalty till attack, movement speed penalty debuff, and cleanse to all slows. Or the opposite. Make everyone slow and attack slow. That's the crush really. And if you're playing support god, if you want to be support, or you're playing assault, take meditation. Okay, good. And because she's a hunter, it's good for you to keep moving. So I say to you, take purification beads. It will help you. Understood? Good. That's the relics, light items. Let me show you her abilities. The first one is a really interesting passive. It's a passive like the same thing like Shang's bunny, but instead of a bunny, this is wolf that attacks shit. It's an ability that she has a pet beside of her, and it has two forms, beast that attacks and elemental that doesn't attack. And the wolf gain 50% of Skadi's attack speed and gain 110% of Skadi's movement speed. And here comes the interesting part. Minions need to attack it 5 times for it to lose 1 health. But the god and its abilities, basic and abilities, will lose 1 HP for 1 each attack. HP 1 attack, 2 HP 1 attack, you know. 1, 1, 1, 1. All that shit. Like Kumbakana's passive. You know, the balls. When she goes, he goes down, he goes into sleep. And you need to hit him in a period of time. So that those balls turn off. And when it's turned off, he dies. The same goes to this wolf. And just to be interesting here, she's a combo god. Yes, I know, she's a combo god. But she's an interesting combo god. I'm gonna start with her too, because it's her poke, her chase, initiate, escape, etc. You understand where I'm going with this, right? Anywho, this is a pet command. Every time you put a point in this beast, he gain in rank 1, you know, when he goes rank 1, he gain a dash attack. Like Nuwa's clay soldiers. In his third rank, every kills he does, enemies, all enemies, gods, monsters, minions, it heals him. But in the 5, Carl's basic attacks gives God a 10% increased movement speed. So if you're looking at this, the maximum, it had no cost, the cooldown is 1.5. It's a toggle ability. Anywho, let me show you the rest of her abilities. But first, let me show you her third. It's an self and enemies. Yes, it is. It's not a bullshit really. Every time she put points in her abilities, it gets larger and larger till it gets 4 points larger than the default radius. And if enemies are where the initial damage begins, they gain 190 damage plus 60% of your physical power. And then it goes to tick. And it has 10 ticks inside of it. It says how. Ground for 5 seconds, the icy area deals damage to enemies that touch it and continues to deal damage every 0.5 seconds. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, two, three, you know, it's 10 ticks. 10 multiplied by 25, that's 250 damage, if the god are inside of it. But here comes the funny part. They will not stand of it because of its effect, really. Enemies, when they go to the permafrost, they stops and they cannot move. And where they are moving, they will just keep forward. Dealing damage will not move, but they can still jump and dash and all that shit. But they cannot move where they want to be. But Guardian instead, if she plumps in front of her, she gain 40% movement speed while standing in it. She can just be a fucking speed demon. And after she goes from the circle, she persists 40% movement speed for 3 seconds. That's good, really. And time for hers first. It's a line ability, goes through everything, except for balls. But minions and gods, it goes through. And here comes the interesting part. Yeah, just listen, okay? It does 290 damage plus 8% physical power, that's already above 300 damage. But the slow is 40%. We are in Apoash slowness right here. For 3 seconds. And here comes the arrow effect. Colorless basic attacks deal double damage to targets afflicted by piercing cold. So if you afflict an enemy with piercing cold, you just say to your wolf, your number 2, run it and smack me in the ass. He will deal double damage. And if you want to be an ass, you work like this. You put permafrost on your enemies so they cannot move or something like that. Then do piercing cold, so when they are outside of the circle, they are slowed for 3 seconds. Then you use Rune of the Hunt, so your wolf keep attacking them while you are attacking them. Understood? Time for her ult. It's a stim in a sense, but just listen to it. It's a root for 2 seconds. It works like this. You and your wolf gain the ult, and they deal, are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. 8 ticks of damage inside of the winter's grasp. 8 multiplied by 5, that's 45. You gain a 450 damage over a period of time. And 2 seconds of it, you are rooted. But it's not like the ult is on, you cannot go to her because you can get rooted. No. You need to be inside of the area when she activates to get rooted. It's like Artemis Trap. When you step in it, when it activates, you get rooted. But if someone else steps in it, they're rooted, but you will not get rooted. It's same thing, really. So here is the combo. Permafrost, Piercing Cold, Rune of the Hunt. And if you notice them that they are running away, or your wolf are almost died, Winter Grasp. They're rooted, dealing damage. You wolf, and you are basic attack it. It, you're dealing shit and damage. And it deals double damage because of the Piercing Cold. Do you understand now why she's an hybrid between attack and ability? I don't say that you can build her to only be ability user or basic attacker. I can only say this. She works when she's a hybrid. Thank you. How should I put points on her? Well, I start off Piercing Cold because of the wave clear and slowness. And then the reason this is cost nothing and it's already on 0.5 cooldown, I don't gonna use it yet because my wolf will only get fucked, really. So I take Permafrost instead. And now when I have some kind of, I can displace them and dealing slowness, now I take Rune of the Hunt, because now he has a reason to go for it. And now I want more slowness. More slowness equals fuck you really, but should I take Winter Grasp now? And the answer is no. Why? Because the best way to use Winter's Grasp is when your permafrost are 20 points, you know, default radius. Because the Winter's Grasp is 20. So it overlaps. So I take instead Piercing Cold, because more slowness. But I cannot take any more Piercing Cold, and it takes two more to get another. So he gains kills will heal him. So I take Permafrost. Permafrost. Now I take the Winter's Grasp. And then I take Winter's Grasp again. The reason is reiteration. More tick damage. And more annoyance. And then I take Piercing Cold again. And again. And now I deal a really nasty amount of slowness. And he will deal double damage still. But what do I need to do now? More radius? No, I don't need to, because that's default. So I take the Rune of the Hunt. Rune of the Hunt. Rune of the Hunt. Rune of the Hunt. And then I take, are you ready? Winter's Grasp. Winter's Grasp. Permafrost. Permafrost. Winter's Grasp. This is how I'm gonna use her. Remember, if you have any better ideas where to put your points in, please do tell. But this is my build. It's my fault if I do it bad, and it's my correct choices if I did do it good. Anywho, you have seen the abilities, you have seen the items, you have seen the relics. Let me show you in a game. I have a match. I picked Scotty, and I'm locking in. And as always, I really hope you enjoyed this video so far, because I'm going to cut this out, because I don't know where my allies or my enemies found a guard and locked in. And as always, I will see you shortly. Bye bye. This is our team. Thanatos, Zeus, Scotty, Athena, Izanami versus Morrigan, fuck you, Awelix, Susano, Noah, Kusenbo. Physical, magical versus magical, physical, magical, magical. Assassin, mage, hunter, tank, assassin versus wildcard, hunter slash assassin.
Assassin. Defeat our enemies,
warrior, mage, and tank. Thank you.
Good luck. Have fun.
Yes, well indeed. This is just getting perfect, really. I want purification. Let's see here. I want you in instant, normal, instant. One of each. I think I'm going to switch my wolf to quick instead. The reason is, I am going to try to spam my wolf. Because it's really dumb. Well, the reason is
be right back.
Okay. Never mind. I'm so dumb really. I can take it normal because oh, the beginning. Only in the beginning. She the fuck you want? Oh shit.
Retreat!
Okay. I'm going to need. Oh shit, did I see?
Ooh, Calder.
Oh, yeah. Shut up, Kitty. So, yeah. Okay. Oh, God damn it. It's just perfect, really. Did someone say anything? No. Okay. It's someone stacking, no?
Save yourself! Enemies behind us!
Yeah.
An enemy has been slain.
This is. What the fuck am I with the over there, really? Nothing.
An ally has been slain.
Fuck that.
They're seeing cold.
Retreat! An enemy has been slain.
Stay alive.
Killing spree! Ultimate is down.
Okay.
Okay. Retreat! Defend! On my way! Out of battle! An ally has been slain! Retreat! Yep.
I'm not there yet. This is just getting better and better.
Battle ready.
Really now? I am. Fuck. This is fucking awesome.
Let's
This is so
ooh,
shit there.
And it's like in there.
I need you. Dreaming of a fine match, sadly but not. Oh no.
Should have brought your skis. Tolder, attack!
I'm going to need you.
Watch your step. The hunt begins.
Defend middle lane.
Wait, did he just leave me?
Double kill.
Jesus, really? He just fucking left me. Ah, oh, okay. Fuck you too, guys. Really? Fucking lame.
Okay.
My heart is fucking racing right now.
Be right back. Okay.
Hey.
should have brought your skis.
Retreat! Out of battle. An enemy has been slain. Sorry.
Running around at the speed of sound.
Battle retreat! Ready. Fuck you, we are fucking tornado. Okay. Save yourself! On my way! Enemy ultimate incoming! Killing spree!
Oh.
Watch your step!
Killing spree! Can this be? Enemy spotted!
Attack!
Yep. Be right back.
What doesn't kill me makes me stronger. Ooh, cover.
An ally has been slain.
Oh, fuck you. Yeah, that's fine. Well,
an ally has been slain. Be careful.
There you are. Should've brought your skis.
On my way. Retreat.
Really? My curse didn't work. My base didn't work.
Thank you.
It was a good game, man. Yeah. Sometimes when you think you're going to win, you lose. So it's the law in games sometimes. You think you're going to win, but then you fucking lose. Anywho, that was quite a good player. I was scary. Anywho, I thank you for watching, and remember, to like, favorite, comment, share, and subscribe to this video, and of course this channel. And if you enjoy this video more than I do, then please comment down below and tell me everything. And as always, I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Okay?
Okay.
Bye-bye.